Welcome to the second video training series on the use of Adobe Sign. The initial training for Adobe Sign was released in January of 2020 and covered detailed instructions on how to seal documents in general and how to seal record sets in particular on every page, which at that time the AES Board Rules required every page to be sealed by each and every engineer who had responsible design for all or any part of that page. So you not only had to seal every page, but some pages had 2, 3, 4, 5 engineers that had to seal that page. And the person setting it up had to determine where those seals went in terms of white space. So there was an awful lot of work that was involved in setting the documents up. Many of the DOTs, CDOT included, have embraced electronic signatures in an attempt to lessen the load or speed up some of the work that professional engineers have to do. One of which is how long it takes to set up record sets. Heretofore, the traditional hard copy method was to print a paper plan set, and if it were large, wrap it up in a big container or two or three, and send it around via FedEx to the various consultancies or whoever had to seal various pages of the record set. It not only was time consuming and expensive, but we only ended up with a paper plan set in the end, which couldn't be stored very easily without being scanned. And it was just an expensive, time-consuming process. So the DOT, CDOT included, as I mentioned, have set out on to use various dedicated programs like Adobe Sign to allow engineers to seal record sets electronically. So the first series of videos basically showed how you would set up, as a professional engineer, how you would set up a plan set for sealing electronically and route it electronically. There was an awful lot of steps in it. You'll see that in a moment. But the true promise of the efficiency of speed and ease of setup for electronic signatures wasn't really realized because the setup took so long. That was unfortunate, but that's what this video series corrects. If you watch this video series, when you're done, there should be no reason you can't set up a plan set for electronic sealing and have it ready to be routed in 15 minutes or less, no matter how big the plan set is, instead of taking as many as 2 or sometimes even 3 weeks to set up a plan set to have it ready to be routed for sealing. What this video series is not about, it is not about detailed instructions of how to use Adobe Sign or Project Share. They'll be mentioned within the context that you have already taken the first video training series. If you haven't and some of the steps don't appear easy to you, then it's probably because you may need to go back and review those videos. So we're starting from the premise that you know how to use Adobe Sign, and hopefully you've sealed a set of record sets already, and we'll begin from that point. So what are the challenges associated with sealing record sets the way we've done it since about January of last year? Well, as I mentioned before, it's a very complex process and very time-consuming to set up large plan sets. Obviously, the bigger the plan set, the more the pages, the larger the file size. Each has its own limitations or problems in terms of taking a long time to set up. If you have a 1,000-page or 2,000-page, or even in some cases, I've seen our plan sets be as large as 3,000 pages, at the very least, you would have to have at least 3,000 seals, one per page, if you only had one engineer responsible for the entire project, which is never the case in a larger project. In a small project, you might have a 50 or 75 or maybe 100-page plan set that's handled by one engineer. If it's a chip seal, no structures, nothing else involved, no right-of-way issues, basically just a chip seal or an overlay. That would be a very simple one to do in either process, whether you had to seal every page or a summary page. But as soon as you get any size to that plan and file size or number of pages and a larger number of engineers that have to seal it, the more complex and difficult it becomes to set it up. Particularly because one of the reasons is you have to break the file down into a maximum of 50 megabyte pieces and route those. And the reason for that is Adobe Sign can handle up to 50 megabyte file for routing, for signature. The average electronic signature application can only handle 10 megabytes. So that's a pretty major problem. If you had a plan set that was, say, a gigabyte in size, and I'm working with the one now that's that large. It is 1,745 pages and requires approximately 2,500 seals because not every page has only one seal. What that means is you have to break that gigabyte file into 20 pieces, set each one up, and route each one of the 20 pieces around. After the sealing is done, which might take 2 weeks to set up or maybe longer, then you have to recombine the files, all 20 pieces, back into one piece to have a single file, and then put it in ProjectWise, which is where long-term retention project documents have to be filed according to PD21.1. And one of the biggest, most onerous issues I've heard is that if you make a single mistake, it could be on any one of the 20 component pieces, or it could be if you sent a file out that had the entire plan set in one file. If you make a single mistake, and by mistake, I mean, if you assign an engineer to sign, to seal a certain page, and it's the wrong engineer, it's off by one page, obviously the engineer is not going to seal for work he's not responsible for. That means you've generated an error, and you start over again. I can't stress how much that gentleman on the right shows what the average feeling is for having done this. Although the actual sealing itself, the application of the seal to the plan set when it's routed, is really quick. It's just a mouse click. Setting it up for that process can be and is very onerous. So how do we fix that? How did we do that? We set it up under the requirements of the board rules at the time, but it really caused some problems for our licensed engineers in terms of the time it took to set the plans up. So here's how we fixed it. Number one, the AES board rules, which govern, it's actually the Colorado Code of Regulations. This AES board rules we refer to is really the governing board that controls how, when, where, and under what conditions a professional licensed engineer, architect, or surveyor can and must use that license. Well, that the AES board rules prior to August of last year stated that every single page must be sealed of a drawing plan set. That's why the original training videos were set up the way they were. CDOT has been undertaking for several years and was successful this year to petition the board to seal only the cover page or cover pages of a plan set and have that cover page or cover pages be applicable to all of the pages for engineering design. So that was the major change that allowed these videos to take place. And the estimate that I came up with, but I understand by project engineers I've talked to who have larger plan sets, my estimate was it would reduce the setup time by 90%. I've been told by more than one that on larger plan sets, it'll probably cut down the time to set up the plans by 99%. So one of the first things you have to do is to place the plan set in a project share site, which is most of you that have sealed plans will know about that, but it's a web-based, it's kind of like the equivalent of a box or a box site or a Google Drive, in that it's a cloud storage application, which is associated with ProjectWise Explorer and the project in ProjectWise Explorer. The difference is the project manager controls the share site. It doesn't take any input from OIT, and the project manager is one of his of the share site. One of his or her first duties in getting a set of plans executed would be to place the plan set, doesn't matter how big it is, in the share site, and then invite the team members. Team members would be the engineers who have to seal it, to the share site so they could review which pages they're responsible for their specialty, be it bridge, roadway design, whatever it is. Then the next step would be to set up the cover pages in Adobe Sign and route those. That's all you have to do is route those one or two, three pages, not the 1,745 pages, which is a huge improvement because all of the seals would be on those pages. The only combination you have to do is a recombination of files is to take the plan set and combine it after it's after the cover pages are executed. You have to combine the one, two, or three pages with the plan set. So you have a single portfolio file, and then you place the sealed record set back in ProjectWise, or if you started the eSealing process with Adobe Sign out in ProjectWise first, because the cover pages were in ProjectWise, because of the integration of Adobe Sign and ProjectWise, you can actually start the sealing process, the setup of it, from within ProjectWise. And ProjectWise will hand off the cover pages, for instance, to Adobe Sign. You set them up, they go about the routing process, they get sealed, and when the document's completed, meaning all seals are applied, Adobe Sign will pass the cover pages back to ProjectWise in an encrypted format, in the same folder they started out with. But it can be done either way. You can use the integration, or you can simply place the cover pages in Adobe Sign, route them, seal them, and then put them back in ProjectWise and combine them with the plan set itself. So this is what the cover page DGN seed file will look like. Of course, without the blue writing here and this gray text box and records, that'll be a lot smaller. But this is what it looks like. It will be, it's required to be, according to the board rules, exactly the same as all the other pages, meaning the borders, the title block down here, that all has to be the same, but it must include a statement. Each page that is unsealed must include a statement that the seals for that page are included on the cover page. That means, for instance, that you can't take an existing record set where you've already designed it, it's already set up, it's ready to be sealed. You can't just use the cover pages because none of the supporting pages would have the statement saying that the seals for that page are on the cover page. So you can only use this option on new plan sets where you have not already begun design and used seed files that don't contain this language, for instance. So you'll either use a page 1 or page 2 or a 3-page DGN seed file for cover templates. Why? Well, it tells you that one page like this, this white space up here, a one-page cover page for a plan set will cover 16, well, it'll handle 16 seals and scope limitations. That's 32 blocks, actually, that fill up this white space, top to bottom and left to right. A two-page cover page will handle up to 32 seals and scope limitations. And obviously the 3-page version handles up to 48 seals and scope limitations. This is for additional information. If you'd like to review the balance of the board rules, once you've seen the options that we're gonna cover in that video on just the option for sealing cover pages, there's a link at the top of the resources tab that you can click and it'll take you right to the DORA site directly to the URL where the board rules are kept. And the top one is always labeled the latest one or current version. You click on it, you'll have your own personal copy of the current board rules. For any questions about the option itself, as it says, contact Kagan Wilson at this address here, and she'll be happy to help you.